Hello everyone, today we are going to discuss Boolean operators. Many of you are probably wondering, what in the world are Boolean operators? Well, that is what this video is about. Boolean operators are named after the 19th century English mathematician, philosopher, and logician George Boole. They are a form of logic that are used in library databases such as Academic Search Premier, JSTOR, or the Library Catalog. They are also used in search engines such as Bing. By using Boolean operators, we can connect search terms together into a basic search statement. There are three Boolean operators: AND, OR, and NOT. Let's take a look at each of these by seeing how they affect our ability to search for cats and dogs. Let's take a look at AND first. If I search for cats and dogs in the library catalog, I'm going to find anything that has both the words cats and dogs in it. When you use the Boolean operator AND, it makes it so both of the words around the AND statement have to show up in the search results. OR makes it so that the results that appear in my search can have either of the two words in their content. However, they don't have to contain both. In this case, I will get material about cats, dogs, and both cats and dogs together. Generally, OR statements are used to connect synonyms together, such as cats and kittens. Also, by putting an OR statement in parentheses, you can separate it out from your AND statements to get better search results. As you might expect, the Boolean operator NOT works by removing a word from the search. So, if I search for cats, not dogs, I'm going to find everything that is about cats that does not contain the word dogs. NOT can be a bit tricky to use, because oftentimes it will remove valuable resources. In this case, it might remove something like an article that talks about proper cat nutrition, but then goes on to talk about dogs. Also note that the order of words is important here. For example, dogs, not cats, will get you completely different search results than cats, not dogs. Now that you know about Boolean operators, you should be able to get better search results when you are trying to find resources in databases. Just remember that if your search terms don't work the first time, try moving something around so that it works better. Thanks for watching. And as always, if you have any questions, please feel free to contact us here at the Stuart Library by clicking on the Ask a Librarian link on our website.